The holidays are such a special and magical time, but they can be a bit stressful, and my house is no exception. Case in point, this home video I shot on my cell phone of my two boys. Oh, the joyous sounds. That was a snapshot of them around Christmas last year, a bit overwhelmed with everything happening around the holidays. And while you may be stressed out about the shopping and traveling, your kids might get a little stressed as well. And joining us now is Kate Rickard, a licensed psychologist at St. David Center in Minnetonka. Thanks so much for coming in.
Yeah.
How can parents prepare to help out their children around this time of year when it comes to their stress level?
Well, I think one of the most important things to think about in this happy and stressful time is really about, are we helping our kids think about what they know as the expectations of who are we going to see, where are we going to go, how long are we going to be there? You know, other helpful things is sort of checking ourselves too about how are we feeling about where are we going, who are we going to see, how are we going to get there. And there's some really great ways to help. Part of it is teaching them who are we going to be with. You know, sometimes they might not remember great Aunt Sally that they met, you know, 2 years ago, and helping them be a little bit familiar about who the family or the friends are that they're going to be with. Other things that can be helpful for kids at this time is to have some kind of consistency in routine.
Sure.
You know, we all know how important naps are. And, you know, at holiday time, they're just as important. Same with bedtime. So the closer we can stick to some of our kids' usual routine around food and naps and sleep is really, really important. Also having something that's familiar with them. It could be the stuffed blanket, maybe familiar food. You know, if your kid's really into PB&J, bring it along just in case it's not going to be, you know, served at grandma's house. And things like that can be helpful for our kids.
A lot of folks travel around this time of year to see family, even out of state. Any recommendations, advice for when you're out of town?
When you're out of town, I would say definitely think about having kid time. So things that they usually do at your house. Again, it might be, you know, if they're really into certain board games, or, you know, little Josh is into Legos like my son is at this time. Bring some of those things so that they have that sense of familiarity. Plan a little extra time if you're traveling. Sometimes that car ride, there might be more, you know, stops than you planned, and you kind of want to be able to do that instead of, come on, we got to go.
So I think this is the season of the season of deep breaths, right, for parents and their kids.
Yes.
Once in a while, we just all have to take a deep breath, breathe in, breathe out.
And tell your kid that you got to take a deep breath, because
right.
it really models for them that you're aware that your body's a little, being a little excited or a little nervous,
sure.
and then they can learn how to do that too.
Great advice, great tips. Thanks so much for coming in, Kate. We sure appreciate it. Stay